Hi, this is Tharum, and I'm doing a demonstration of Gestype, which is a keyboard app for visually impaired and blind users. So when I open the keyboard app, imagine that in the bottom half of the screen, there are two blocks, one on the right-hand side and one on the left-hand side. When you hold the phone in both your hands so that your thumbs are pointing towards the screen, the left half is under your left thumb and the right half is under your right thumb. So the way it works is, if you take your left thumb and you swipe from left to right, it'll always be an A. So you can swipe anywhere and it'll be an A. Similarly, up to down will be a B, right to left will be a C, and a down to up will be a D.
C, D.
And single tap is E and double tap is F.
E, F.
So you might have noticed the clockwise pattern here. The same clockwise pattern repeats under your left thumb. So your left thumb will be G, H, I, J, K, and L.
G, H, I, J, K, L.
To get the rest of the alphabets, all you need to do is tilt the phone slightly away from your body. So you will hear a vibration noise. When the vibration stops, that means you are on the other screen. So in the other screen, the pattern is exactly similar. Under your left thumb, you have MNOPQR, and under your right thumb, you have STUVWX.
STUVWX.
To get Y and Z, you can put both your thumbs together and swipe anywhere from left to right.
Y.
And Z is right to left.
Z.
Y and Z works on both the screens.
Y. Z.
So these are alphabets. Okay, so a quick tip on tilting the keyboard. So as I mentioned earlier, when you tilt the keyboard slightly, the alphabets change and you hear a vibration sound. Now, say suppose you want to pick a different orientation to type and you want to type while lying down. So I change the orientation. I take the phone in my right hand and I tap it on my left hand. So when I tap it on my left hand, now I can tilt the phone from the other orientation and get the alphabets to change. Now, if you don't like tilting the keyboard to get to the next set of alphabets, there is another way. The way you get to the other set of alphabets is by holding one thumb down on either the right half or the left half. So for example, if I hold my right thumb down on the right half.
Switch.
So you hear switch. That means the left half has switched to the other set of alphabets, which are
M, N, O, P.
And if I hold my right thumb down or my left thumb down, the right half switches to the other set of alphabets.
Switch. S. T. U. V.
So now spacebar and delete. So spacebar is with both your thumbs in two different halves, just swipe down.
Space.
And delete is with both your thumbs in two different halves, just swipe up.
D. Delete a D.
And return is with both the thumbs in two different halves, just swipe in different direction, as in, say, left thumb could go from up to down and right will go from down to up.
Enter.
Or the other way around.
Enter.
So now to numbers. To get to the number screen, take both the thumbs and go from outside to inside at the same time. So you just have to make a slight motion from outside to inside and it'll work.
Numbers.
So when you come to numbers, the pattern is exactly the same. On your left thumb, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And right thumb, you have 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. If you double tap anywhere, you'll go back to the alphabets.
1, 2, 4, 6, 7, 9.
And double tap anywhere, you'll go back to the alphabets.
Alphabets.
Now symbols, you go from inside to outside with both your thumbs.
Symbols.
and there are only 5 symbols. The symbols are the same on your right thumb as your left thumb. So you have
at, slash, hyphen, full stop, question mark,
and you double tap anywhere to go back.
Alphabets.
So as you become good at this keyboard, I have some advanced functionality built in. This is autocorrect. What autocorrect allows you to do is that you don't have to switch the alphabets, as in you don't have to tilt the keyboard, or you don't have to long press
switch
and switch the alphabets. So it automatically understands that in the right half, for example, a swipe from up to down could be an H,
H,
or it could be a T.
T.
So if, say, suppose you miss out on tilting, I'll show you how you can type.
Delete a T, delete an H.
So I'm going to type this is
H, H, I, G, this space.
So as you can see that as I type space, it auto-corrected to this, because T could be typed the same in a similar fashion as H, and S could be typed in a similar fashion as G. So this allows for a very fast typing method. So let me show you how I can type, hello, this is a good day.
Deleted, deleted S, deleted H, H, E, L, L, C, hello space, H, H, I, this space, I, is space, A space, G, C, C, D, good space, D, A, Y, day space.
And the way you can hear back what's on the screen is just bring both your thumbs together in either the left half or the right half and just long press.
Hello, this is a good day.
So finally, two quick suggestions on using the keyboard. One, make sure your swipes are short and smooth. This will give you the best result. Another tip is there's a lot to take in with the keyboard. So go slow, get the alphabets first, then go to the numbers, then the symbols, and then try the autocorrect. Alright, great. I hope you enjoy using the keyboard, and please feel free to reach out to gestype@gmail.com for any questions. Thank you.